adjectives. Today I phenomenally decided to almost complete on adjectives so that we can pitch into something new. I will request now SS in this to read the. I will request Bhakar sir, maybe let me change that. That has been a public demand so many times to read the entire slide for us.
Adjectives say of quantity without giving number, quantifying.
Adjectives telling about quantity but without giving the number. These are called quantifying determiners. Next.
Ice cream, a little rice, not many peppers, too much salt.
Too many peppers. Okay.
Lots of insects, plenty of money, some foods. Is there any milk?
Is there any milk? See, this is all about quantity. Can you give me some food? It can be this much, it can be this much, it can be something very small also. Correct? Then there is lot many people, too many people. What is that number? You are not sure. I have enough cash in my pocket. I have enough cash, say that.
I have enough cash.
In my pocket.
In my pocket.
To survive for?
Survive for.
Next 7 days.
Are
you getting what I'm saying? That enough word is not telling exactly how much. This enough cash will be different in Bangalore for 7 days, different in Pandalpur, and different in USA for 7 days. Correct, Amma? But they still is indicating the quantity. This is the slide about adjectives, say that.
This is the slide about adjectives.
Which tell the quantity,
without being
specifically a number. Correct? So I want you to give some more examples on this. Please raise your hand and contribute. Yes.
Most of you.
Can you make a sentence? Would most of you prefer tea or will it be coffee? Would most of you prefer tea or will it be coffee? I have not said would most of you prefer tea or would most of you prefer coffee. That would be unnecessary repetition.
Many a times we can avoid
repetition of phrases. Although it will be grammatically correct, it will be boring to the audience. One more rule whenever you say something. How have I played the sentence? Would most of you prefer tea? Is detailed. Then I suddenly say, or will it be coffee? Or will it be coffee? So I have used the quantifying adjective most of you. But in the second half, I have avoided using it. Are you getting? Are most of you getting this? Are most of you understanding this? Are many of you understanding this? Is it that few people are understanding this? Is it that only few people are understanding this? These are different words which talk about quantity without telling the exact number. I want you to give some 4-5 examples on this. And then we have one activity of the day. Yes, can you make a sentence? Sir is giving a word sufficient. I am requesting you to give a sentence. I have sufficient time to finish my syllabus. I don't know whether students will get sufficient time to prepare for their exam. Sufficient we can use in many ways. Wonderful. Next. See, sufficient is used not about solid thing now. It is being used for abstract concept called time. Yes. Next.
Can you give me a pinch of salt?
Can you give me a?
Pinch of salt.
Pinch of salt. Chutki bhar. Pinch of salt. Those who don't know this word, catch up. After dictionary installed. Pinch of salt. Pinch is also a verb, by the way. Pinch is also a verb. My neighbor is continuously pinching me. Somebody can hear say that. This is a common complaint observed in Montessori classes. My neighbor is pinching me. Are you getting? There is something in my heart which is pinching it. There is something in my heart which is pinching it. Every Saturday I get this pinching thought that why Sunday is not a holiday. Every Saturday I get a pinching thought in my mind why Sunday is not a holiday. See, pinch is being used in so many different ways. Correct? Can you give more sentences on this? Only few of them are interested to come for the picnic. The word few is taken. Yes. I wanted to have more rice, but very little was left in the pot. I wanted to have more rice, but very little was left in the pot. See the poetry of the significance of the words. What I have told is, बहुत थोड़ा था लेकिन मुझे ज़्यादा चाहिए. This is about life. Many times it happened. There was, I wanted more rice, but very little was left in the pot. Little also is adjective of quantity and more is of this. Yes, you can use the word maximum and minimum. I suggest maximum number of people attend this. I don't mind even if they understand the minimum. I suggest maximum people should attend this lecture. The lecture is very complicated. It may happen that minimum people understand it. Correct? This can be used of the word maximum and minimum. Any last two contributions?
When she called me, I was busy with some work.
While she called me, I was busy with some work. I was busy with some work. Some is becoming quantifying adjective. Some is becoming a quantifying adjective. Now, there is one exercise, one activity that we are going to do today. Please stop passing the attendance sheet for a while. It should be kept as it is. Stand still. I am doing one activity. Please help. See, in our class, there are some students who are shy. They never speak. They are not contributing heavily. There is one activity that I am going to teach you today. It's a pedagogy technique that will make everybody contribute and they will enjoy it also. So this is one group. This is one group. Up to here there is one group. Up to here there is one more group. Then up to the row with row before and row after algorithm. That is one group. Can you all raise your hands? Okay, in this entire group of people is one group. Can you all raise your hands? Now here, these three rows is one group. Okay? And the last four rows, including Devisar and Nana, that is one more group. Can you all raise your hands? Can you all raise your hands? Okay. Now, we'll take 4 more minutes. There are still 4 minutes left out and we are going to finish this activity. In a planned manner, within 4 minutes, we are going to complete this particular activity. Can you see words on the board? There is Praveen, there is color, there is jungle, there is banyan, and there is spring. Within next 3 minutes, the group should come up with a story. The group should come up with a story. It can be 2 sentences, 3 sentences, whatever. But you should come up with a story as a group, and one leader from you will tell that story, 2-3 sentences story, and that's the activity of the day. We know so many adjectives. We know nouns, pronouns, verbs. Let us practice it now. That's a group task. This is the first time I am giving you a group task. Your time starts now. Complete immediately. Your time starts now. Complete immediately.